Greg Bamford de Remax Saskatoon est un bénévole qui apporte une incroyable contribution à plusieurs organismes sans but lucratif de sa collectivité. Le parcours de Greg, à titre de bénévole, a débuté dans les années 2000 alors qu'il a décidé de s'impliquer dans un programme parascolaire local ainsi qu'à titre d'entraîneur pour la Kinsmen Inner City Hockey League. Il a joué un rôle clé au sein de Opération Santa en livrant en personne la magie de Noël à des familles dans le besoin. Ensuite, Greg a rehaussé la barre en organisant des collectes de fonds pour les œuvres caritatives de grande visibilité, Wake Ride et Sask Country Showcase. Il a aussi mis à profit ses compétences en leadership au sein de comités et de conseils d'administration. Puis, en 2018, Greg a participé au Sanctum Survivor Challenge, une expérience qui a changé sa vie. Pendant 36 heures, il s'est mis dans la peau de personnes en situation d'itinérance dans sa collectivité.
I have to admit, I thought it was a cool challenge, but I thought, it's a cakewalk. I'd be easy to be able to live on the streets for 36 hours. And then I started asking questions, I guess, after I had been asked. And I reached out to Dion Mastic-Shields, which is our current executive director for Haven Family Connections. She used to work in the homeless sector. So I reached out to her and to understand why homelessness exists and a lot of the struggles that a lot of people have. Learned about trauma, sexual abuse, I guess, mental illness, and a lot of the other things that that affect people to get them into the place that, of homelessness. So going into the challenge, I didn't sleep 2 weeks before it happened because I realized what I was going to see. I'm someone that can't, I guess I can't just kind of move on from things sometimes. If I've seen something and know I can make a difference, then it's kind of something that I guess I feel like I'm obligated to do.
So the Sanctum Survivor 36-Hour Challenge basically takes 10 local community leaders, Greg being one of them, and they're stripped of everything that they have, including their clothing. So they have to choose clothing that's been donated at the beginning of the 36-Hour Challenge, down to their shoes. Greg was partnered with a friend and colleague of mine, Alice Kuipers, and her 8-year-old son, Theo. The year that Greg participated, we also experienced kind of torrential downpour. So it was cold, it was rainy, and then the added challenge of having an 8-year-old with them, making sure that he was fed, that he was warm, and that he had somewhere to rest.
It was very clear from the very first moment that we met that Greg's passion lies with supporting inner city youth particularly. He talked a little bit about the work he's done with the Kinsmen Hockey League. He talked about his work with Wake Ride. And when we got to the food bank, we were given food that basically sustained us over the next 36 hours. I think both of us were shocked to see children lining up at the food bank line. Not that we didn't know that. A number of the food bank's users are children and mums and families, but actually standing in line with people who this is their everyday reality, understanding we could go home to our warm beds and a cooked meal in a very short period of time, began to make both Greg and I very vulnerable and open to the experience that followed.
From there, we saw a lot of things that maybe I'd never seen before or thought about firsthand, being in line with kids. That was probably the biggest thing, was just seeing what a lot of kids have to deal with on a daily basis. And that probably affected me probably the most.
Greg a été inspiré par son expérience du Sanctum Challenge et a voulu contribuer davantage. Il a eu l'idée novatrice de créer un site web qui permettrait aux membres de sa collectivité d'accéder à de l'information sur des organismes sans but lucratif locaux, sur leurs programmes et leurs besoins en temps réel. Greg a uni ses efforts à ceux de sa partenaire du Sanctum Challenge, Alice Kuipers, pour donner vie à cette vision. Après de longues consultations avec entre autres des organismes sans but lucratif, des chefs autochtones, des politiciens locaux, des concepteurs de sites web et des donateurs, Greg et Alice ont créé onesmallstepsk.ca. Le site a été lancé avec succès à la fin de 2020, malgré les défis supplémentaires posés par la pandémie de la COVID-19.
He developed One Small Step as a way to try to make sure that people knew how to contribute to nonprofits, and also that people in the community knew the stories of nonprofits. Why is this work important? What difference does it make? What's the impact? And he knows that nonprofits, you know, we're nose to the grindstone, just trying to do the work on a daily basis. And we don't always have time to do that self-promotion.
Executive directors have told us that it just makes it much easier for them to be able to quickly update and share their needs with the general public so that they can get on with the work that they need to do.
Greg has decided to take his connections to the community and utilize them in a way that promotes the work of nonprofits in our community, but also the many barriers that exist for vulnerable populations in our community. And I think that is something that is truly commendable, especially because this isn't Greg's world. Greg's world is real estate.
He spends absolutely hours and hours and hours of his time volunteering because he profoundly believes that we can each of us make a change.
Making the community a better place, I get out of it way more than probably I feel like I give. So it's just rewarding.
L'Association canadienne de l'immeuble est fière de remettre le prix canadien Realtors Care de 2021 à Greg Bamford pour sa contribution et son leadership inspirant.